So what is going on, guys? It's Anna. It is 2:20 p.m. No, it's 1:20 p.m. Sorry. March 17th, 2014. It's Monday. I'm about to get dressed and go to my baking class because I unfortunately still have school. But the last week has been spring break, and I went to Georgia and I came back, and I've just been having a lot of issues lately. And this video is really going to talk about how I'm feeling being finally in maintenance, and just overall just a feeling of dread. And so this is going to be a trigger video in case you have depression or if you have an eating disorder. This is a trigger video, so either watch at your own risk or go find a cat video to go watch right now, because Anna's about to get some serious smackdown on here. So, as you can see, many things have happened. My hair color has changed. This is my natural hair color. It's a dark brown. I'm still getting used to it. I don't know if I like it or not. I've been used to being blonde for so long. Like, I don't even think I've had brown hair in any of my videos. Like, it was bleached blonde during my weight loss, and now it's here. It is now been almost 3 weeks since my dog has passed away, and it's been really hard. I've gained weight, and I've lost a significant amount of weight, and then I gained it back. I went and weighed in today instead of Wednesday just because I needed to really go talk to my counselor. I was having some serious issues. Today I weighed at 153.5, and I planned on doing the 5-1 again this entire week. The next 2 weeks I planned on doing the 5-1 and just not saying anything. I stupidly said that out loud, and Janelle convinced me that that's not the way, and I know that's not the way, and I probably wouldn't have been able to stick to it as much as I would have liked. So, I'm not on the 5-1 anymore. I'm still in maintenance or transition, wherever the hell I am. I'm in a place. I'm at 153 pounds. I'm supposed to be taking a photo next week, next Wednesday, for my weigh-in to submit it with my Medifast Happy After submission. And the new center counselor at my center was so thrilled, and she's like, "Oh my gosh, you're definitely going to be chosen. You don't even look like the person you looked like before you lost the weight." And I'm thinking, yay. Woo. Woo for me. I feel awful. So, this morning, or over the past few days, we've been baking a lot in my house. We don't usually bake. I was trying some recipes for school. I made biscuits yesterday, and I ate them all. Most of them. I didn't feel guilty about eating them at all throughout the entire week. It wasn't a binge episode. A binge episode is when you sit down and you eat copious amounts of food in that one sitting. And then you feel guilty about it afterwards. But I didn't do that. I actually ate them throughout the day. They were small biscuits. I honestly didn't care. I didn't feel bad about it until at nighttime when I got one of the bigger biscuits and I made a chicken sandwich out of it. It doesn't sound like a big deal, but it was. I don't know what it was. Maybe it's because I woke up and I weighed in here at the house when I was 155. And I don't know. I started crying. I started crying because of my weight. And that's not really a good thing. And I just had a lot of issues, a lot of thoughts running through my head. So I made a post, and I posted it on my blog. My blog link is down below. If you want to go try a hunt and find it, if you actually want to read it by yourself slowly so you understand what I'm talking about. But I was going to send this to Janelle this morning, but instead I went in and I let her read it. So I'm going to tell you what it says. "I made homemade biscuits yesterday and ate them. I ate most of them because they were good. And to be honest, during the time I was eating them, it was timed out, not all at once. It didn't necessarily feel like a wrong thing to do. There are some things that when I eat copious amounts of it, I instantly get the feeling of, this is bad for you, stop. And then I usually stop. Or at least try. I ate these biscuits throughout the day. Sometimes I had maybe half a teaspoon of sugar-free jam to to go with them, but overall, I just ate them plain. I didn't go for the big biscuits either at first. I ate the small bell-shaped biscuits I had created. Anyway, during the day, I ate these biscuits and didn't feel ashamed about it. Didn't feel like I was gaining weight until the evening after I'd eaten the last of the biscuits and used the last two large biscuits as a bun for a grilled chicken sandwich. I woke up today and weighed myself. I felt fat. I still feel fat. I got on the scale and it said 154 or 155. I can't tell. It's an old non-electronic scale that just has that little ping bar that makes you fatter every time you step up on it, and the ping bar raises higher and higher above the numbers. I saw the number it finally hit, and it dawned on me that I was overweight now once again. Overweight by the definition of my height, weight, and age. Do you know what I did? I walked out of the bathroom, I sat at my desk in the chair I'm sitting in right now making this video, and I stared blankly at nothing on the screen. I kept going over the thoughts in my head. How was it that it was bad for me? Why is eating that bad for my body? I don't understand. I worked out hard. I've been working out. I've been eating healthier. I've been eating. I began to cry. I'm ashamed of myself. My weight, the way I look, the body I have. I hate it. I hate it all. I don't want to eat. I don't want food anymore. But I know that it is unrealistic and dumb to think, but I think it all the time. What if I could go without eating? Wouldn't that be wonderful? Oh, why didn't I stop eating the biscuits? The healthy popcorn, those homemade cookies that I couldn't stop eating. By the way, which was gross, and I think those chocolate chips were stale. That's on the point. Why can't I just stop eating? Why? What have I done to deserve this? Why does my body forsaken me? Why can't it burn and burn and burn? Why can't I just cut out the fat and have a slim, toned body like these pictures that keep popping up, that I keep seeing? I am disgusted with myself sometimes. I think about carving the fat out of my body and falling off the wagon. Being fat was easy. Once you were fat, you stayed fat. Being skinny is hard. It's hard work. It's hard trying to understand and discover what your body can and will do versus what it can't and won't do. I do not like me. I do not like the way I look. I do not like me. I never have, and I never will. I disgust myself with my very presence sometimes. I'm disgusted. That is what I wrote this morning. That's what I posted. And so far, I have received about, I don't know, 11, 12 messages about how I am an inspiration to girls younger than me, to women older than me, how I should not give up. See all I have accomplished and all this stuff I know. Janelle told me again in my head just to get over it. It's just, I don't know. Sometimes I just wonder why. Why am I doing what I'm doing? It's obviously not getting me anywhere. And I know it's unrealistic for me to think I'm going to look like one of those people in the magazine, when even those people in the magazine don't look like the people in the magazines that are portrayed. And I think society is full shit when I see these photos, and I think they're causing more harm than anything. I see skinny people, and I wonder why I can't look like that. I'm upset that my collarbones aren't sticking out far enough. I'm upset that I can't see my ribs anymore, unless I'm turning my body. I'm upset that my hip bones don't pop out. I'm upset that my thigh gap comes and goes. I'm upset that I eat. And that is something that no one should feel. But I feel now more than ever that I am not the definition of beauty society wants me to be. And therefore I am taking it out on my body. And so I binge eat, or I attempt to, or I don't want to eat, or whatnot. Or it's gotten to a point where I question myself when I'm eating a completely healthy, perfectly sized portion meal, if I should finish it all, simply because I don't want those extra calories. What if my body doesn't burn them? So that's what I have been dealing with for the last 2 weeks. And I gotta say, Thank you, Lucy, for dying on me. She stares at me. She's right there with her urn. You see her urn? There she is. Right there. She stares at me. And I stare at her. And I talk to her. But I went today, and I got MetaFast food. As you can see, I'm all stocked up. I'm not back on the 5-in-1. I'm still doing my maintenance plan. I'm working out a lot more. I'm working out a lot harder, to be honest. A lot more weights. I'm trying to run more when I do cardio. I've been passing over 10,000 steps a day. If you follow me on Fitbit, you probably have seen me been jumping just numbers. Like, I walked 13,000 steps yesterday. I don't know. I hit 10,000 this morning at 8 a.m. It's only 1:31 p.m. now. I got class. I'm going to be walking around in that. Some days are just harder than others. It's put you in a little perspective of my depression zone I'm currently in. I'm supposed to be going to talk to a psychologist later on this week about my mentality towards my body. Every time I feel like I eat something, I feel like I puff up like a balloon. So that's not good. And I know most of you people won't get this when you're on MetaFast. You won't get this mentality that I have. Most people don't when they lose weight. It's just one of those rare cases. I have a mentality. And if I don't do anything to fix it, if I don't talk to anybody about it, it's going to turn into an eating disorder. And we don't want that. And last, I'm not going to talk to my parents about anything. God forbid I tell them I feel bad because I ate an extra apple, because I will never hear the end of it. So I'm going to go. This is an update video. My brown hair. Trigger video. That's how I feel. I just feel like blah. I feel like poop. I feel fat. I feel like I look fat, but I don't. I know I don't, but I feel like I do, and I don't. Because everyone tells me, you look fine. You look great. I mean, I'll stand up for you guys so you can see. See what I'm dealing with. I know we're going to get messages saying, Anna, you aren't fat. Perfectly fine. That's how I feel. This is me. Right here. It's my body. I just feel fat. But I'm not. And it's good that I can tell that I'm not fat. Even though I feel it. I can see it. That's it. That's all I got for you guys today. Trigger video for depression and eating disorders. Great. Let's see if I ever become a happy ever after on MetaFast, because damn, I would not want me to be one of their spokespeople. I would when I'm happy, but not when Anna's depressed. I'd be the worst spokesperson. Alright, I'm leaving. I gotta go get dressed. Bye, guys!